Bed Bath & Beyond sinking today after activist investor Ryan Cohen sold his more than 7 million shares and options in the company. And amid the company's scramble for liquidation, reports just out that some suppliers are halting their Bed Bath & Beyond shipments due to unpaid bills. We've reached out to the company and let you know if we get more. Joining us now is Tom Sosnoff. He is founder and CEO of Tastytrade. Tom, this stuff is just so confusing. And I have to admit, as someone that really studies the fundamentals of retail, does make me want to rip my hair out a little bit. We know that things at Bed Bath & Beyond are not necessarily smooth sailing. However, I also don't know that it was worth the sell-off that we saw this week. We know there's so much going on Wall Street Bets and Reddit and what's going on with Ryan Cohen and the following that he has. Can you explain to us what is moving shares of Bed Bath & Beyond, and should they be moving? If you are an investor that wants to try to get in on this trade, what do you do?
Well, it's almost an impossible question, but I'm going to give it a shot. So, you know, Bed Bath & Beyond, you have to put a little context around it. It's only a billion-dollar company at current prices, right? When you talk about the size of Bed Bath & Beyond, it doesn't take too much to move the stock up or down a couple of dollars. But I think when you get into the kind of, like, let's call it frenzy that that Bed Bath & Beyond just went through the last couple of days, and when you look at where it is today, it's the expected move over the next month is only $5 or $6. It's, I think it's like 565 or something, and that's based on current implied volatility of 200+200%. So when you think of Bed Bath & Beyond, what you have to think about as an investor is you have to look just like you said, you have to look past the fundamentals, and you have to think about it as here's a $10 stock with a 200+% implied volatility. That means that the marketplace, if you believe in efficient markets like I do, and efficient market theory, and you believe prices are accurate, that means that the expected move at a 200+% volatility is 2 times the upside as opposed to the downside. The downside, it can only go to zero. The upside with the 200% volatility means it can go to 30. And so it's priced accordingly that way. And I think that's what you saw in the last week, was this incredible upside skew, as we call it, in the pricing. And you saw that type of tape action.
Now, look, I'm not going to ask you to be an expert on any sort of like insider trading allegations that are floating out there. I'm not making the allegations about Ryan Cohen, but obviously he got very publicly involved in shares of Bed Bath & Beyond in March. The company very quickly made some changes as a result. They changed the board around. In the time since, they did push out their CEO, whether that was directly Ryan Cohen's involvement or not, I'm not sure. And then, of course, he said, look, I'm going to sell the stake, and then shares move again. I guess my question is, if you're a trader and you're trying to follow the smart money, should you be following someone like Ryan Cohen? Or is that just too dangerous when you're talking about these retail stocks that are moving so swiftly, not necessarily on fundamentals?
Well, I am a trader. That's all I actually do. Yeah. And I did trade a lot of Bed Bath & Beyond. But I think you have to understand, you have to take Ryan Cohen out of the equation if you're a trader. Because, first of all, anything that he's going to say publicly, he's probably going to say it after he's already done whatever it is that he has to do or he wants to do. So I think there's two things to recognize when you are trading stocks, and you can call them meme stocks, you can call them stocks that have had this kind of move, but there's two really important things to do. And the first thing is, whatever you do, stay small in your size, because forget about all the stuff you read about 20-year-olds in college and Ryan Cohen's of the world. Just stay super small, then you can handle everything. And I think that's the single most important thing. The other thing is, just recognize that if everybody's on one side of the market, and this is how we think as traders, and it doesn't always work, but most of the time it works, you're much better off, instead of trying to follow the trend or follow the fundamentals, mm-hmm. you're much better off playing the role of a contrarian.
Okay, fair enough. Well, Tom Sosnoff, we wish you luck out there with your trades. It's some pretty wild times in the retail
space. Fingers crossed. I'm going to need it. Thanks.
Thank you for being with us.